please don't test me. I'll put you in the death squeeze, just like an orange in the summer.
The first 2 weeks of recovery and 5 months of training flew past like the thief of time. Most of it was spent training, because who wants to show up to an assassin's gala unprepared? Not I. We've learned one another so well that if we went through that bombing now, we would have hiked that 100 plus miles to the agency, instead of taking the easy way out. We've worked on learning one another's triggers, strengths, weaknesses, and one's character under pressure. Everything I need to know about this man has come to light, and the truth is, Michael and Jean forced me to see this man for the blessing he is. They love him and trust him with everything. Even Michael has shown great strides in becoming a young man. There's things in life that a mother can't teach her son, and because of Mustafa, I see that now. We have a month before we leave out. I think we should take a family photo. What do y'all think? Great idea, Mom. That would look nice over the fireplace. I'll take the picture, Mustafa mentioned. But your family too. You have to be in the picture, Michael said, hugging Mustafa's leg. We're all family. I'll set the camera on a timer, Jean said with a smile. I agree. Your family, I whispered, in Mustafa's ear. Everything was set up and we were in position, just waiting for the camera to take the picture. After a few minutes, Jean got up to check the camera and the flash goes off. This may have happened 4 times before we got the perfect picture, so we thought. Mustafa and Michael went into the kitchen to prepare dinner and do homework, while Jean and I went through the pictures. Immediately, I started blushing. Every picture that was taken, Mustafa was looking directly at me, and it seems that his eyes are brighter in these photos compared to others. I took hold of Jean's camera and started rifling through to look at other pictures of him. Yep, there's a difference in his eye color. My heart started to thump harder and harder until I got to the photos when I was in a coma. That's when I noticed the love in this man's eyes.
Wow.
What? What do you see? Please tell me you didn't swipe too far back. Those were some crazy nights, okay? Don't judge me, damn it, Jean said. No, and gross. I was looking at pictures of Mustafa and ran across the pictures you took of him when I was out of it. Why didn't you tell me you took these? I wanted you to fall in love with him and your own, not because you can see his desire for you in his eyes. I left well enough alone and figured I would make mention of it after Michael goes to bed, but I couldn't wait. Watching him cook and help Michael with his homework from the doorway made me want to jump his bones. I laughed to myself and went to help him by taking over assisting Michael with his homework. No, ma'am, this is our man time. Please go join Jean, Mustafa gestured for me to leave. Join me where? I'm coming in here for some taste testing. Jean left and sat next to Michael. I got up and stood next to Mustafa, trying to get some samples for Jean and I. You need to go rest up, so I can whip you into shape after dinner. Wait, I'm not saying you're not in shape. I mean as far as stamina. Not like you can't keep up, but, Mustafa said, digging himself a bigger hole by the second. Jean and I started laughing and you can see the embarrassment run slowly across his face. I wrapped my arm around his waist. Don't start fumbling over your words now. You still owe me from stealing that kiss, I said, hip-checking him. Wait, y'all already kissed. I want details. You kissed? When? Michael jumps out of his seat. There's nothing to tell. And yes, I kissed her and she pushed me away. Mustafa shied away. Billy, Jean yells out. Mom, Michael follows up. Girl, please. It was temporary insanity on his part. He had a near-death experience, and I was the closest to him, I mentioned, still holding on to him. It wasn't temporary, Mustafa softly mentioned. Then the unthinkable happened. He gets in front of me, holds my face in his big strong hands, and comes in slow with his moist full lips. His hands went from my face, slid down my body, forcing my hips to come in tune with him. When I say amazing, I mean amazing. The passion of his kiss makes my body melt. I felt like it was just the two of us, until I heard a loud gasp. Did I realize we're not only in front of an impressionable child, but falling into one another in front of Jean. When I went to pull away, he held me tighter, pulling me closer to him. I couldn't resist. I wrapped my arms around his neck, caressing his head with one hand and holding on to him for dear life, as if I never want to stop. Mom, you're going to make him burn the food. This is man time. All girls need to leave, please, Michael yelled out. Yeah, give me food and get a room, Jean and Michael laughed. When we finally parted ways, I wanted nothing more than to be back in his arms, but I digress. I scurried back to where I was sitting at the table, then decided to remove myself altogether and head outside for some fresh air. I was hoping to be by myself for a minute to process my feelings. I took a seat on the chair furthest from the door, but before the porch wraps around to the other side. Did I do something wrong? Did I take it too far? Mustafa said worryingly. Not at all, I just needed some air, I replied. I don't want you to feel rushed. I'm willing to wait for the next kiss, however long it takes. I just thought you should know that, but the table is set, so when you're ready to join us, we'll be waiting. Wait, I yelled out. He stopped midway. I pushed him against the wall and damn near attacked the man. There was something deep down telling me to rip off his clothes right there, but I held myself to a higher standard. Not because I wanted to, but because when I started nibbling at his neck, I could hear Michael calling my name. Damn, it's like that, Mustafa asked with a smile. Definitely, there's something you do to me that I want to explore, I explained, while trying to pull away. No, you don't. I'm not going to let you get me all excited and leave me out to dry. You have to do more than just be sweet, look handsome, and care for my family the way you do. Anything other than a kiss, you have to work for, Mr. Mustafa. I don't have a problem with that. I just want to let you know, you're going to be my wife one day. No rush though, but it's going to happen. Jean and Michael came to the door and I moved away from Mustafa as fast as I could. We're hungry in here, basically starving, Michael said looking directly at me. We're coming in. Give me a minute, please. They turned around and closed the door behind them. I needed one more kiss, just one more. He pulled me over to him. Let me love you. I thought you already did, I mentioned. I'm in love with a person that just noticed me. I want to show you that I know how to love you, before making love, to you.